October 27th, 2015. Can we please have the roll call?
Barbara Brenner.
Here.
Rud Browne.
Here.
Barry Buchanan.
Here.
Pete Kremen.
Here.
Ken Mann.
Here.
Satpal Sidhu.
Here.
Carl Weimer.
Here. People, will you stand and join me in the flag salute?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, just a few announcements before we get going. If you have your cell phone, if you can put it on silent or vibrate, that would be great. If you're handing out stuff during our one public hearing or during the open session, it's really good if our clerk up front gets a copy for the records. We also had a committee of the whole meeting this afternoon where we had a discussion regarding the proposed resolution approving the Whatcom County 2016 Annual Construction Program. And we passed a resolution to add that to the introduction items this evening. First thing on the agenda is the approval of six sets of minutes. The Board of Health minutes for May 5th, 2015, the regular County Council meeting for June 9th, Special Committee of the Whole for June 23rd, regular County Council meeting minutes for June 23rd, Board of Health minutes for July 14th, and the Special County Council for August 4th. Is there a motion?
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Any discussion on the minutes? All those in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Those pass unanimously. We have one public hearing this evening, which our clerk has just went to get the sign-up sheet for. It's on a resolution approving the sale of an access easement over Whatcom County-owned property. And I think this is going to be a short and sweet public hearing. I don't think we need a staff report. We've talked about this before. I'm going to open the public hearing. One person signed up. Anybody else that wants to speak to this certainly can. The one person that signed up was Bill Newman. Wrong sheet? All right. Is there anybody else that wants to speak to us about it, this easement? Seeing no one, I'm going to close the public hearing. What's the wishes of the council?
I'll move approval.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? That passes unanimously. We're going to move right into our open public session. This is where members of the public can speak to us about anything. But before you stand up and get going, we understand because we've got lots of emails and phone calls that there's some interest this evening on the flyer that went out regarding the jail. And I suspect there's a lot of people here to speak to that this evening. So before we jump into our open session, I'd just like to make a brief statement about the council's role in that and what we knew when we knew it so people understand that. You know, in September of 2014, the county executive requested and received the council approval of a contract between the county and the DLR group for the purpose of providing a full design services for the Whatcom County Adult Correction Facility and Sheriff's Deputy Headquarters. Now, that contract, which was about 28 pages long, was in a packet of 400 plus pages that the council reviewed, and we did approve that contract. Within that contract, 28 page contract, there were two items in the task section on 20-some pages into it that mentioned a ballot measure prep and ballot measure mailer presentation in one item in the compensation section that talked about reimbursable costs of $28,000 for those things. Council members, after we approved that contract, were not provided with detailed information about how the funds would be utilized, and we did not participate in any way in decisions regarding the timing, formatting, content, or design of the recently mailed jailer mailer. The county executive also would like to make a brief statement before we hear from the public about this or anything else you want to talk to us about. Mr. Louse.
Thank you so much, Mr. Chair. I do have documents that I would like to provide for the clerk and for the council. And I'm going to spend a few minutes reading this into the record concerning the jail mailer. And thank you so much for allowing me this opportunity. After 5 years, we're at a point in time where next Tuesday, November 3, the voters of Whatcom County will decide to support or oppose the sales tax measure for the construction of the replacement jail on LaBounty Road in Ferndale. The council and the administration has taken very deliberate and crucial steps to prepare our organization and the community for this vital decision. In April of 2011, the council passed Resolution 2011-14 establishing a jail planning task force for study and recommendations on a proposed direction for the county jail. In September of 2011, the Whatcom County Jail Planning Task Force unanimously agreed that due to overcrowding, life safety, and physical plant concerns in the main jail facility, Whatcom County needs a new jail. In early 2013, based on the Jail Planning Task Force findings and recommendations, the council and the executive retained DLR Group for jail planning, architecture, engineering, and other services to plan for the replacement jail. In late 2013, on recommendation from the executive and other team members, the council made the decision to purchase the LaBounty Road property in Ferndale for the appraised and purchased, which was appraised and purchased for approximately $6 million for the future location of the Whatcom County Jail and Sheriff's Office. In September of 2014, the council and the executive approved a contract with the DLR Group to seek a conditional use permit, which was issued in March of 2015 by the City of Ferndale. In June and July of 2015, the council adopted Ordinance 2015-025 and the amended Ordinance 2015-037, establishing the Incarceration Prevention and Reduction Task Force. And in June of 2015, the council approved Resolution 2015-024, authorizing the jail facilities and sales use tax ballot measure to be brought before the people. The September 30th, 2014 contract with the DLR Group authorized public outreach on the project. This outreach included providing a coordinated informational publication, including images of the existing facilities and renderings of the new facility. The planned public information schedule for the project included developing materials for presentations and for the ballot measures. The council's role related to the mailer, while important, was limited to the authorization of funds within the budget and the contract that approved the preparation and distribution of the ballot measures. I take full responsibility for the design, delivery, and content of the informational mailer. During the preparation of the mailer, my team, the prosecuting attorney's office, and I worked closely together to ensure consistency with state law on this matter. According to Public Disclosure Commission guidelines, one jurisdiction-wide objective and fair presentation of the facts per ballot measure is appropriate. In the PDC Interpretation 0402 Guidelines for Local Government Agencies and Election Campaigns, the Commission held that it is not only the right but the responsibility of local government to inform the general public of the operational and maintenance issues facing local agencies. Accordingly, the interpretation states that the PDC will presume that every agency may distribute throughout its jurisdiction an objective and fair presentation of the facts for each ballot measure, typically a jurisdiction-wide fact sheet mailing. Such a presentation must accurately portray the cost and other anticipated impacts of the ballot proposition and must not promote or oppose the proposition in the tenor or tone of the language used. Simultaneously, we reviewed the PDC guidelines on informational mailers and consulted with DLR, who has experience in preparing informational mailers requiring PDC compliance. We sought PDC review. However, the PDC stopped providing review of mailers last year due to their budget constraints. We worked diligently to make the mailer factual and objective. My team and DLR group consulted with the PDC, and to the best of our knowledge, the mailer follows their guidelines and is consistent with state law. DLR group received specific guidance from the PDC that one mailer is appropriate, a list of registered voters may be used, that the mailer should not directly advocate for or against the proposition, and that there's no specific timelines designated as it relates to the mailer and the election date. The informational mailer content was informed by the Skagit Community Report that was issued just prior to their sales tax ballot measure in August of 2013 election. I would like to submit a copy of that report for your review and comparison. In our community, you will find similar informational reports developed by school districts, fire districts, and other jurisdictions that have communicated to their voters on important ballot issues. The mailer was designed to give voters in our community solid and accurate information on a large and complex jail project. After so many years of good work and so many good decisions by the council, we stand today with a solid project now poised to be decided by the voters of Whatcom County. While I am proud of all of the work on this most important and significant criminal justice challenges, I do regret that this entire jail project and the associated public informational mailer have resulted in controversy among some people in the community. With that controversy in mind, I stand before you, ready to move forward shoulder to shoulder to achieve a sensible solution to this long-standing community challenge of a replacement jail. I do want to state that the entire jail plan, the documents and agreements associated with the plan, as well as the informational mailer, was developed and distributed with all good intent by competent, ethical, and conscientious people working within Whatcom County government. I'm proud to serve alongside each of them. These people are committed to the mission of Whatcom County and strive every day to protect our residents and ensure the health and prosperity of Whatcom County. Again, we are looking forward to the decisions that the voters of Whatcom County will make on November 3. We can always learn from the work we do together, and I am willing to use what I have learned from this project in our important work together in the future. Respectfully, Jack Bowles, County Executive. Thank you so much, Mr. Chair, for allowing me to read this into the record.
Thank you. I think we want to hear from the public. And
I wanted to, you made a statement that doesn't actually cover what, and mine's like
I think statements. Everybody can make any statements they want, but let's listen to the public first. Let's move on. Go ahead, and you can speak to us about the jail flyer or anything else you want. 3 minutes, and I didn't explain the rules. When we get down about 30 seconds of your 3 minutes, you'll get a warning that time's about up. And if your name's more complicated than Smith or Jones, it'd be great if you'd spell it for us.
My name is Bob Burr, B-U-R-R. I have two residences in Bellingham, and I am royally peeved. I absolutely detest the influence of money in politics. That's one of the reasons I have such great respect for Barbara Brenner. But I'm not here to talk about coal money tonight. According to another one of McEachran's flawed opinions, that would not be allowed. I am here to talk about the lowest dirty trick that I have seen in 20 years of following Whatcom County politics. I refer to the flyer that I received in the mail one day before my ballot arrived. This slick piece of one-sided propaganda impressed me. I thought it was very well done. I wondered what propagandist for the jail industry had paid for it. I then proceeded to go read the Herald, which I had put aside to read through my mail. It turned out that the dastardly propagandist who paid for it was me and all of you in this room. Oh, I knew that Jack and Bill wanted the new jail, but I always thought that they were ethical men. I was saddened and disillusioned that they had misappropriated my tax dollars and yours in an effort to influence the election. If the jail measure passes, I'm sure it will be challenged in the courts because of this. Was the flyer legal? Probably not. Probably just one more bad opinion from our county attorney, who is also featured in the flyer. Was it ethical or appropriate? Definitely not. And Jack Lau's
30 seconds, please.
Weak response about all of you having approved it made me lose more respect for him. I know that you are, some of you are extremely upset with this as well. I would ask you that either in private session or public forum, that you interrogate those involved in this egregious violation of public trust.
Thank you. Next, and we have two microphones so people can line up on either side of the room.
Dina Jensen, Birch Bay. Last week, I wrote a letter to the council to register my complaints about the unethical Whatcom Council Community Report jail mailer, asking that because of this unethical action by county employees and representatives, that Proposition 2015-1 be invalidated and that Jack Lowes withdraw his candidacy from this election. What I wanted to express tonight was my appreciation for the Restorative Community Coalition and other members of the community who have been working so hard to present alternatives to the expensive and oversized proposed jail that will rely heavily on private businesses to support it, needing those businesses to be fed by members of the community in the form of taxes, and offering requiring an even larger burden of support from the families of those who are incarcerated. The Restorative Community Coalition and their allies are thoughtful and compassionate people. They are unflagging crusaders for human justice and human rights. And I believe a proposal to spend money in a way that would eliminate inhumane conditions and institute programs that would shorten jail stays and decrease recidivism would be readily embraced by them. I don't believe they have any sense this would be the result of this proposal for the new jail and the tax to support it, nor do I. Now back to the fact that the last-minute promotional mailer from the county has tainted not one, but two propositions on the November 2015 ballot. Please take action to right this wrong. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, Council. Marion Bedill, Bellingham Southside. A different topic tonight, one of my old standard favorites. Pollution in the runoff, especially in the Lake Whatcom watershed. We recognize that there are several ways to remove chemical pollutants from the waters of stormwater runoff of special interest in the watershed of the Lake Whatcom Reservoir. Please send me either docs or web links data on the alternatives for such filtration for each proposal, preferably in the customary consulting marketplace style of request for proposals, RFPs. We are well aware of the use of vaults with screens and of rain gardens. Some general descriptions are shown at the site, lakewhatcom.wa.us, et cetera, it's in the paper. Also report on any other models as well as major variants of designs for each. Three items in my request. Number one, effectiveness. In common circumstances and at various flow rates, what is the percentage of removal of significant pollutants, especially phosphorus, for each of the alternative systems? Be explicit also for the amount of phosphorus which remains in the runoff beyond the facility for a wide range of flow rates. Item two, costs. For all of the typical alternatives and citing the size of each installation, what are the costs? These must include capital costs and operating costs, both figured on a calendar basis and on an effectiveness basis, dollars per year and dollars per pound of phosphorus removed. Number three, service life. For each alternative, how long will it remain in good functional operation condition? This may be expressed if the system has a characteristic of a periodic renewal, one or more time frames, spans, for renewal of components, as well as a final life of the installation. Thank you for your diligence in protecting our water quality. Marion Bedill.
Thank you.
Evening. Evening, son. Barry Wenger, Bellingham. And it's been a while since I've been here. I see there's more facial hair on the council than the last time I was here. I'm very glad it does not include you, Barbara. So, I'm not here for the jail. I'm actually here to talk about the birds and the bees. And that's the Wildlife Management Committee. I'm on that as one of the scientific land use group. There's the seven of us that are kind of scientifically oriented. But the other part of it is there's four stakeholders that are to be appointed. And I just wanted to express my opinion that I really hope those four people will have two things in common. One is that they understand wildlife, that they really, you know, either enjoy it, they're hunters, they're fishermen, somehow they're engaged in it, not just from like a kind of the philosophical side of things. And the second one, that they're willing to cooperate, look at different issues on that wildlife committee, so that it doesn't become a big polarized issue. I would love to see people from the agricultural community, from the forestry community, because those tend to be large tracts. And as we get closer and closer to the urban core, it's important to have people from the building industry, from the real estate industry, but they need to have a good balance impression of how to work with the landscape. I've done this for many, many years as a professional planner, and when you put in subdivisions, there's many ways you can use a ravine as a open space corridor or whatever, and it benefits not only the subdivision because it's an amenity, but it also benefits the wildlife, so they have a place they can basically get through. And we're not expecting to have cougars and grizzly bears down in Bellingham, although I hear in some quarters in the bars there are such denizens hiding out. But anyway, there are, you know, there's a lot of ways to balance out the human impact and the wildlife needs. You know, there's always going to be somewhat of a conflict, and there's a little bit of a risk. But I think that's one of the things that makes this Whatcom County such an amazing place, that we are actually not like King County. We've got a lot of green areas. We've got, you know, productive farms, productive forestries, and there's a way to balance those things out. So my hope is just that we have a committee that we can actually work through all these issues and provide you with really good recommendations in the future. That's about it.
Are you done?
Yeah.
Sounds like we have a quick question or
sure.
Clarification.
Yeah, it's my understanding the names of the people who are applying are going to go to the committee people we've already assigned for a recommendation to us anyway. I don't know.
It's on our agenda tonight to appoint four of the five of them that have applied. So the plan isn't to send it to the committee to recommendations,
okay.
But you can bring that up when we get there if you want.
Okay. We could talk about that.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hello, council members. My name is Christine Morrow, and I would like to speak sequentially with Teresa Hertz here, as we're both members of NAMI Whatcom County. I'm currently the board chairman, and we're here tonight to present to you a letter on behalf of our membership related to the jail tax proposition. This letter comes from the voice of our membership upon meeting with a number of former board members, as well as our current volunteer resource folks that work in our office and work directly with the public that is increasingly in crisis related to mental health issues, as well as of our teachers' membership coordinators and et cetera. So I'd like to invite Teresa Hertz to join me on the floor here and read to you the letter that has been presented to our membership.
I thought I might go over my 3 minutes, so we wanted to do it together so you won't cut me off, hopefully.
We'll give you a little leeway.
Thank you. As we near another important election, we consider the measures before us asking for tax increases intended to better our community. We reflect on past elections, current taxes, and fiscal responsibility. If it is our desire to become a better, stronger county, this is our duty. In 2008, we pulled together as a community to speak as one voice for Whatcom County residents suffering from mental health and substance abuse issues. Over 300 people, many from social service agencies, gathered at the council meeting to speak on the state of mental health and substance abuse services in our county. the collective voice called out, we're in crisis. The need for a safety net for our most vulnerable population was repeated throughout that evening. As members of the organization that led the movement to support the 1/10 of 1% tax for behavioral health services, we encouraged our membership to stand up and share personal stories, as well as to vote in favor of the tax. The tax passed, authorizing the money to be collected in a special fund to provide mental health, substance abuse, and therapeutic courts. We are grateful for the addition of the 2015 mental health court, school programs such as Healthy Communities, and the success in our juvenile court and detention center due to more robust services. People have been working hard to create programs to put our tax dollars to work. Unfortunately, too many needs are still unmet. The highest need our membership expressed in 2008 exists in 2015, more services to help people navigate a convoluted system. Without an adequate triage center, inpatient beds for substance abuse, enough case managers, housing and employment assistance, people in crisis still end up in jail. This year is different. We are not asking people to vote for the passage of a new tax. Instead, we are asking our community to reject Prop 2015-1, the jail tax. We join with the Bellingham Police Guild in declaring that, quote, this community is in dire need of a secure, safe mental health facility, unquote. Jail is not an appropriate service for those living with persistent mental illnesses or chronic addictions. We share the concerns of the Firefighters Union that the tax may tie up money needed for EMS funding and feel it's irresponsible to lock up 100% of our public safety tax capacity for the next 30 years. While we believe a new jail is necessary, we ask the county to use the 2004 tax exclusively for the jail and the 2008 behavioral health tax for preventative services that will divert people from jail, rendering a jail of the proposed magnitude unnecessary. We agree with Ann Deacon, our county's human services manager, that, quote, no Whatcom County resident needs to forego necessary mental health or chemical dependency treatment just because they have no insurance to pay for it, unquote. However, without adequate services, too many of our families, friends, and neighbors must do just that. They are still in crisis because we do not view the jail expansion as a solution to this persistent problem. NAMI asks you to reject the jail tax. Let's continue the good work we've begun by putting our money into concrete blocks of preventative care rather than concrete blocks to build a 521-bed jail. And that's how we feel.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Patrick Ellis, 4825 Alderson Road, Birch Bay. I'm going to use my uncle's retirement watch from Attica State. He was not a prisoner there. He was a guard there. That's why they let him out, I guess. Now, before I talk to you about when you were talking about arriving at a tax for the jail, and I said, why don't you use a property tax? It's much more stable. So I said, a sales tax is erratic. It jumps around. There is excess capacity. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't think so. I think it needs to be looked at. There's excess capacity in the county tax of $3.1 million per year. That means you can go ahead and tax yourselves or everybody for 30 years or 40 years and go out and acquire bonds for it. It would be a stable tax. The people selling the bonds would trust it more than they would a sales tax that bounces around. All areas would pay into it. The rural areas and the city areas, and everybody would use it. I said it again right here.
Thank you.
Good evening, Council. My name is Bill Newman, 3770 McGrath Road, and unincorporated Bellingham. I'm here on behalf of funding and building a new jail. It is about time that we do so and stop messing around with it. The current jail is unsafe, and for women, it is deplorable. There's one restroom for approximately 24 women. That is deplorable. If those conditions existed in an animal shelter, there'll be a picket line around the block. The cost to build a new jail now would be far less than it would cost in 10 to 20 years. The county and the city of Bellingham has grown a lot in the past 25 years. Think about 10 to 20 years from now, what it would cost the taxpayers to do so. I urge you, and I'd like to know that, I urge you to get on with this and get it done. I'd like to know if any of you would think that not building the jail will decrease crime. I don't think so. As the population grows, so will crime. I've seen it grow in Los Angeles when I lived there for 40 years. It grew. My friends and I tried to warn the county board in Los Angeles about that. They ignored us. We tried to warn the clergy about it. They ignored us, and now it has gotten out of hand. I just noticed today that graffiti has increased in Bellingham. I know these may be young people, but they will grow up to be older people and older thugs. So I urge you, please, let's get on with this and get it done right now. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's James Peterson. I live in Southern Valley, 5 Sunnyside Lane. I'm here about the jail pamphlet. I'm thankful I didn't get one because I would have probably been in jail because I would have been so mad. I think $30,000 or $29,000 for the flyer could have gone better for mental health or drug addiction treatment. The problem I have with building a new jail, I keep hearing the talk, there's going to be 17 beds for mental health and drug addiction. Great. So now people got to get locked up to get help. My question is, why not use the money to build a 30-bed treatment center and split it in half between mental health and drug addiction? And just maybe if we provide help to these people before they commit a crime, just maybe they won't be in jail. So I urge everybody to vote no on this, and I just think that we need to look at preventative measures instead of let's just lock them up. And that's the whole thing. How long is it going to be before this jail is bitted off to a private jail institution? Thank you.
Thank you.
Joan Dow, Whatcom County. I would like to thank the county for this mailer that I received. It's very informative. I depend on information like this to know what's going on, in the same way that I depend on this information that I receive from Mount Baker School District in the mail. Both of these things are very useful, and I thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Maureen Dunaway, 1813 East Smith Road. I also depend on those things, but I was sorely disappointed to find out that there was nothing reliable in that. And I'll just say it one more time. I also rely on mailers from our county to inform me, but this mailer did not inform me. It, as someone else said, was a propaganda piece, and I haven't had a civics class for probably 35 years, but I'm just sure that we're not supposed to spend our tax dollars like that. I'm thinking the pamphlet that we get for the voters' pamphlet is what we're supposed to be looking at when we're deciding how to vote, the pros and the cons, both sides of it. And the idea that my tax dollars were spent like that is unbelievable. And this other gentleman that spoke, I didn't have my own thoughts, so I'm using other people's, but he said that jails don't make us safe, that locking people up doesn't make us safe. And I agree. Whole people make us safe. And that's the problem here. We don't have a place in Whatcom County to help people get whole. And even though we've been throwing money in that direction, you can spend money, but that doesn't mean you get results. And we've spent a whole bunch of money. Ann Deacon actually gave me this whole list of money that has been spent on programs. But the unfortunate thing is it's not making a difference. And adding two beds to the detox in Whatcom County, that doesn't make a difference. So when I think about 521 beds to lock more people up, and we have 8 detox beds in all of Whatcom County, it's amazing. I don't know what we're thinking, but we're not thinking clearly enough, because the people that are in there need to be helped. That's what they need. And they rely on us, who are doing well, to be able to reach out to them. So I'm going to ask the council to distance themselves from the current leadership that we have, because they're not making any sense, and they're going in the wrong direction. And I'm afraid that they've aligned themselves with some big industries that don't really have Whatcom County at their heart. So myself and some other people put together a petition, and we sent you 149 signatures that we just got in a day and a half, and we're continuing to get them, and we're asking for a PDC investigation. We want this thing looked at very clearly. It seems really dirty from the very beginning, and it seems like there's an agenda that's been put forth way before anybody came to the voters
30 seconds,
about
please.
It. So I hope you guys will distance yourself from what's been going on and step back and really take a look and ask some serious questions, and maybe we'll get some serious answers, because that's what we need. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Sandy Robson from Birch Bay, and I'm pretty upset about that jail mailer, very upset, to say the least. And I think I'm upset, although I don't know the rules, that Jack Lowes was allowed to speak tonight. I didn't feel it was proper. He's running for office. I felt it gave him a way to kind of do a mea culpa or explain himself. I don't know the rules on that. It really bothered me, though. And most of all, with that mailer, not counting the part that it's propaganda, it was biased, there were campaign pictures in it. I mean, an actual picture, I think, that was used in the campaign. But most importantly, it misidentified the jail proposition number, which is 2015-1, versus Proposition 1 for district-only voting. And I know for a fact Dan Gibson and our count, at least him, worked very closely with the Charter Review Commission in the charter review process, and he's going to know the name of that proposition and how to identify that. And I cannot believe that it was misidentified in a piece that went out to all the voters, or however many voters there were, and it misidentified that. It never identified it as 2015-1. It labeled it Proposition 1, which is exactly Proposition 1 for district-only voting. And I don't even really think, I can't even believe it was a mistake. I don't know how that could have been made. So I'd like that looked into. I don't know what your all's power is. I'm not very savvy on all those things, but I think it's worth having the not only our county auditor, but the Secretary of State and the Attorney General. I think that is a big problem, and I think it taints the election results, and I don't like it at all. And I guess lastly, I'm sure Mr. Lowes probably doesn't think very highly of me tonight, because when I got in here at 6:30 or so, he was going around and he shook everyone's hand and came up to every single person and very smiley, and he came up to me and said, "Hi, I'm Jack Lowes," and I said, "You're campaigning, aren't you?" And he probably didn't like that, but it felt like that. It felt like that because I'm still upset, and I guess I'm not ready to make nice, as the Dixie Chicks song
30 seconds, please.
I'm not really ready to make nice after that jail mailer, and I just didn't have the words except to say, so I'm sorry I didn't have the words to say anything gracious except you're campaigning, and hopefully next time I might. But I did feel it was improper for him to be able to have any time tonight to say anything about that jail mailer after that went out. And thank you very much for listening.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Ray Barabo, and I'm upset too. I'm really upset, and I'm upset at the people that got ticked off about a perfectly legal mailer. This is high quality. It's good information. I got one Saturday from the Bellingham School District in the mail. Fathom that. And it mentions here that they've got a replacement operations and tech levy
coming out February of 2016. And then summer before last, I got one from the Bellingham Water Department telling me how they're spending their money and what they're doing. And then my fire department, they used to send me a mailer about once a year. They're doing it online now. So taxpayer-funded information, not remember, one person's facts is another person's information. Propaganda. Thank you. Yeah, so you got to realize that what I've discovered is there's a group of people in this community, if they don't like something, it's got to be wrong and illegal. That's nonsense. That is absolute nonsense, and I'm getting fed up with it. So the next couple years are going to be pretty ugly. And just remember tonight, because the people that got upset about a perfectly reasonable, legal mailer started it. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Jean Chadwick, 553 Wild Rose Lane, Linden. I'm a retired educator and served on many bond and levy committees, as well as the building committee at Kendall Elementary in the Mount Baker District. I've also witnessed what can be done in my new Linden community when the many citizens of Linden work together to build, pass a bond issue to build two new schools with a 69% favorable vote just recently. I know all too well the hours that can be poured into committee meetings to recommend design and funding for new facilities and what happens when people sabotage their many hours of work. Many years ago, like 20 years ago, educators were warned that a large wave of children born to drug-addicted mothers would have significant learning and behavior issues. This is a national issue and one we have seen already for many years. At one time, I had a second grader that I was trained in physically restraining because he could walk in and start throwing chairs, and I learned very quickly how many children can be affected, and that was one of many, unfortunately. Public schools are, unfortunately, alcohol and drug use make an enormous issue for our law enforcement personnel as well. Public schools are no more responsible for a school-to-prison pipeline, which is a national issue, I realize. Schools have been strong advocates for students and families for many years. I'd like to let you know that Chuckson Middle School in 2011 started a restorative justice implementation for the school district. All the school districts have been working very hard on this issue for many years, and this is to keep students in school and help their families as much as possible. As an educator, I've tried to educate myself on all sides of important issues to resolve before voting. I'm very concerned with the city and county councils supporting so much of the planning to build a replacement jail and then confusing the election process with protestations of things happening without their knowledge. I'm saddened that this has been an ongoing conversations with city and county councils since 1997 with no replacement yet other than the temporary jail, which this is supposed to solve.
30 seconds, please.
And I'm also saddened at the lack of trust and respect for our elected officials who often put public matters before personal and family time. And I include all of you in that, so thanks for your time. And I also have Linden School District brochures that are sent out several times a year. Thank you.
Thank you.
My name is Wendy Tarkin. I also live in Bellingham. And my name is Wendy Tarkin. I also live in Bellingham, and I'd also like to talk to this about this brochure. I received. Actually, let me start over. I don't remember what day it was, but I read the article in the Bellingham Herald telling me about the furor and the uproar, and mentioning in headlines allegations that the county council, the county executive, the sheriff had acted improperly by sending this out. The article went on to talk about the misleading information, the one-sidedness of it. Halfway through the article, there's a little blurb saying,
Well, actually, they checked with the Public Disclosure Commission that they ran the mailer through their law, through their lawyers, before publishing it. It seemed to me that it was a non-article. I hadn't yet received that mailer. I live in Bellingham. Maybe 98225 gets its mail last. I don't know. So I looked into it, and I Googled some of the key phrases, and those key phrases I'm hearing echoed throughout here tonight. And I find them in the writings of specific people. Strategic communications planted as if to make an issue. The circle of communication went around from the Herald to different social media sites, the same people citing the same source over and over. I would, as I have a master's degree in information management, it seemed to me that this information trying to make the council, the executive, look bad was planted. With regard to the jail, I would like to say I don't think it's the best place for mental health. I don't think it's the best place to receive medical services. But no one is arrested and booked into the jail just for having mental issues. The jail itself is crumbling. I don't know how many of you have been in there. It is a safety hazard. It is a liability. You know this. Every firefighter that has done a drill in that jail knows this. Every policeman that has booked someone there knows this. The police union, local unions, I should say, have put out information saying they think the money will be squandered, saying that they may want to build a new police station instead. I ask you, are the lives of those incarcerated less worth less than the lives of animals?
30 seconds, please.
That's all. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Booth.
Doralee Booth, Birch Bay. I've worked closely with Sheriff Elfo on the Sheriff's Citizens Advisory for many years and also served on the Jail Planning Task Force in 2011-12. As a result, I understand that the local jail plays a critical role in the law and justice system and in the safety of citizens of Whatcom County. It is the hub of the judicial system, a self-contained community where legal standards need to be met to avoid significantly liability risks. Deliberate indifference to those standards is a legal liability risk. I applaud those of you on the council that understand this and have advocated for the new replacement jail. Law enforcement cannot do its job protecting the public without a right-sized jail that is safe and humane. There's been considerable noise, confusion, misinformation, and outrage perpetrated on the citizens of Whatcom County by the opponents of the new replacement jail for whatever reasons. Recent insinuations made against the county leadership do a great disservice to Whatcom County. I support the county community report mailer, which was sent out to educate voters. I am glad voters have the opportunity to read the factual information provided to make their decision to agree or disagree with the proposition and then vote. The Blaine School District ran a $45 million bond issue in February 2015. The district ran an ad on the entire back page of the Northern Light for several weeks and sent informational material home in the kids' backpacks to parents. Not everyone in the Birch Bay community was pleased with the information regarding the ballot measure, since no purchase of property for the elementary school in Birch Bay was mentioned or being funded, and no elementary school is planned for Birch Bay community in the next 15 to 20 years. Never mind that 60% of the students come from Birch Bay. But we were informed on the bond issue and could vote yes or no accordingly. The idea that this mailer paid for by tax dollars was an extreme abuse of power, or that the net effect of this mailer is disastrous to freedom, or it was a despicable piece of misrepresentation because it didn't say what I wanted it to say, is beside the point. The school district had the right and the responsibility to inform the public. I want to thank Executive Jack Louse and Sheriff Elfel for all they have done to give leadership in the planning for the new Whatcom County Jail. Building a jail is one of the largest funding issues a Whatcom County can face. The county website contains 42 pages of jail planning with 418 prepared documents. The discussion has gone on for 18 years. I'm grateful, and I applaud our county.
Thank you.
Raise this up a bit. My name is Teresa Erickson. I live at 2914 Cottonwood Avenue in Bellingham. And I, too, want to add my thanks to Executive Louse and the sheriff for preparing that mailer. I was actually out of town when it all hit the mail and the, you know what. But when I came home and I collected all my mail, I had a number of political flyers, including that one, an informative bulletin telling us about the facts of the upcoming proposition. To be honest with you, as I look at that, I hear the outrage that we have spent tax dollars on a mailer to inform the electorate about a critical issue in our community. And the real issue, as I see it, is not the fact that we spent tax dollars on that, but actually the content of that mailer. Because, as they say, a picture is worth a thousand words. Now, I have personally talked to friends who have absolutely no interest in the jail. The people in this room do, and we all know how we're going to vote. We're either going to vote to have the conditions that we still have go on, or we've said 20 years is enough, let's move on. But the people outside this room, they don't have the involvement or the personal interest that we do. A friend I was talking to today, her response, when she opened that bulletin for the first time in her life and got a real visual of what our jail was, she says, wow, this looks like a third world jail. Bingo, that's exactly what it is. It's a third world jail in America, in our community. That is absolutely appalling. I cannot believe that we're arguing about replacing or not replacing a jail. So I did a little bit of figuring myself today. I thought, okay, $28,000 to do this mailer. Now, this is figures for yesterday, but in the Whatcom County Jail bed count yesterday were 229 inmates. There was approximately 11 deputies on duty, 8 nurses, 3 mental health professionals, 2 medical records personnel, court personnel up to 5, kitchen staff, contract kitchen staff, 3. So there's a total in the jail, approximate, of 261 people. Now you divide $28,000 by 261 people, and we can stamp the price, the value of a person in that jail at $107.28. I got news for you people. A life is worth more
seconds,
than that.
30 seconds, please.
To me, the lives of the people in that jail are worth way more than $107.28. My money goes to people. My relationships are more important than a couple of pennies on every dollars of purchase. I don't understand why this is an argument.
Time.
Wow.
Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Irene Morgan, founder and secretary of the Restorative Community Coalition. There are several of us that would like to read the statement that we're making this evening, and we'd like to go in succession, please.
That's fine.
Thank you. This document is cross-referenced and hyperlinked at restorativecommunity.com, and it's a PDF. This is a request for investigation to the Whatcom County Incarceration Reduction and Prevention Task Force and Whatcom County Ethics Commission. It's a notice of improper conduct. Section A, election interference. Whatcom County mailed proportional material for a ballot measure that seems in violation of RCW 4217A.555 and WAC 390-05-273. 1. Please view the original mailer file or a copy arranged to present the flyer as it was designed to be read. 2. Consult with DLR Group, advising the county on jail design and construction. Produce the mailer, Whatcom County Contract Number 20140913, stipulates Exhibit A, Scope of Services Public Outreach, that the consultant will develop a coordinated message and graphics to support the message. The message appears to be supportive of the sales tax measure. It is not clear how a coordinated message and supporting graphics is intended to constitute a fair and objective fact sheet as required by law. 3. The DLR Group has received millions of dollars for fees on this jail project from research, planning, permitting, designing, and now promoting the tax to fund the jail. We assert that promoting the jail tax is a conflict of interest. 4. Jurisdictions are permitted to distribute a jurisdiction-wide fact sheet on ballot measures, but there is strong evidence that the mailer was sent to select voters instead of property addresses. It is not clear how select voting recipients constitutes a jurisdiction-wide distribution. 5. The mailer includes photos, some with quotes, from 3 elected officials, 2 of whom are running for re-election in this campaign. 6. The mailer confuses 2 different ballot measures, twice referring to Proposition 2015-1, the jail tax, and Proposition 1, district-only voting.
30 seconds, please.
A separate message regarding Chapter Review Commission proposed amendments regarding the method of electing council members. 7. The mailer includes feel-bad pictures of real inmates in overcrowded conditions and feel-good pictures of imaginary future inmates in a pristine new jail condition in violation of PDC guidance. 8. Stakeholders have identified a number of inaccuracies in the mailer. A. Sheriff's statement avoids response.
Reading that, just give us your name before you start.
Community Coalition. A. The sheriff's statement avoids responsibility by implying overcrowding and conditions are decades old. That is misleading. The taxpayers already approved 2 taxes in 2004, the jail tax, and in 2008, mental health tax, to provide funding for these same problems. That information is missing in the report. B. The sheriff implies that failure of the jail and inhumane conditions are the result of lack of funding. This is not true. The Sheriff's Department has received millions from previously approved taxes and not used them to solve the problems taxpayers expected. The jail has been poorly maintained and allowed to run down. Hundreds of people are currently being mistreated and housed inhumanely inside the current jail. C. The mailer fails to disclose that the tax ascribes 100% of public safety sales tax funding for the jail, meaning future taxes will be needed for emergency services. D. The mailer infers that the county has obtained the agreement of all parties through a comprehensive and complete planning process. This is lacking substantial facts. 1, the assumptions of the so-called needs assessment used to justify the jail expansion raised considerable public concern, but were never questioned. An earlier unbiased review found many planning deficiencies, but they were never addressed. 2, the city of Bellingham, representing almost half the county population, has not signed off on the agreement as alleged. 3, the jail task force was an appointed group that excluded critical voices and limited public comment. 4, there is no evidence of a pre-approved public participation plan for the jail project intended to be funded by the sales tax measure on the ballot. Most citizen comments were dismissed as being outside the scope of the FEIS. 5, the executive fast-tracked the sales tax through the council to the ballot without collaboration with critical community partners, as the mailer suggests. E, Executive Jack Lowes takes credit for $11.5 million in behavioral health services spending. This is misleading. Most has been spent on planning and bureaucratic expansion. There is little evidence this money made it to the streets for
pre-booking
versions as recommended by the county's own staff. F, the prosecutor suggests the tax will improve jail alternatives. In fact, the prosecutor's case management and unwillingness to review cases or release people from the jail is in large part responsible for the overcrowding. The Restorative Community Coalition outlined 15 ways the executive branch overcriminalizes citizens with bureaucratic revenue-generating tactics. Their recommendations have been steadfastly ignored.
Time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Karen Price. The Restorative Community Coalition outlined 15 ways the executive branch overcriminalizes citizens with bureaucratic revenue-generating practices. Their recommendations have been steadfastly ignored. This is especially disturbing in light of the USA Today review of the FBI statistics reported by local jurisdictions, wherein Whatcom County has a racial arrest disparity greater than that of Ferguson, Missouri. Section B, fiscal mismanagement. Besides election law issues related to the impartiality and veracity of the mailer, there is a number of related taxpayer concerns about the misuse of funds. Number one, there is evidence that the construction, interest, and operating costs of the jail proposed would potentially bankrupt the county and necessitate a sale lease back to the Real Estate Investment Trust, a financial strategy that has not been publicly discussed. The size, design, and odd location of the jail strongly support this concern. Two, disturbing peculiarities regarding the jail property price, acquisition, and site selection have been noted. Number three, the purchase of the jail property was completed in a 10-day administrative rush without public comment, 45 days after the publication of the SDEIS following a three-day weekend, and therefore the council had time to read the FEIS. The executive and the DLR group both advised the council that the public hearings were not necessary in considering the jail property acquisition. Number four, the decision for the jail site and style was presumptive throughout the planning process. The only alternative was the no-action alternative, not really an option. In particular, our central location currently available on either side of the courthouse was never considered despite being indicated as preferred both by the U.S. DOJ site selection and the NICA jail design guidance. Number five, the extent of jail improvements funded by an earlier 2004 jail sales tax is unclear. The county represents the jail as being in disrepair despite tax funding. Major public safety personnel organizations have noted that the language for both the earlier approved and the proposed jail taxes allow receipts to be squandered on other things.
30 seconds, please.
The Police Guild and firefighters have adopted this position. The Sheriff's Guild posted a link to this notice on their website newsfeed. This has been removed. Number six, the fate of 2008 approved Hargrove tax funds earmarked for mental health and chemical dependency is unclear. Service provided organizations have seen little indication of these funds and are reaching those in need. The county has been spending money, but not in pre-booking diversions internally
Time.
Identified.
Thank you.
My name is Joy Gilfillan. The county has been spending money, but not on pre-booking diversions internally identified by the county's own staff as the most necessary, important, and cost-effective. Section C, fiduciary responsibility. The county's fiduciary responsibility to the safety of taxpayers is in question, including the inmates, employees, and people of Whatcom County as per Whatcom County Charter, state law, and federal law. One, consideration of alternative jail sites such as a central jail near the courthouse was avoided. County documents rationalizing this choice are false and misleading. The county received constant information about jail alternatives for over 5 years. These were systematically ignored. Two, substantial funds were produced from a confusing $18.7 million property fund swap, including large contributions from the supposedly dedicated road fund
and the Economic Development Investment Fund, a fund for which revenues, expenditures, and balances are not published in the publicly available budget report. 3, a pattern of skirting the law has been evidenced with regards to election laws, environmental and planning procedure, and housing of inmates in humane conditions. Whatcom County Code 1.28.100 instructs the sheriff to remedy inhumane conditions, but has not been followed. Inhumane treatment is clearly admitted to by the administration in recent testimony and press statements. The conditions remain. The administration has substantially increased bookings, while statewide bookings are down, and focused efforts on lobbying and selling the sales tax. 4, there is pointed concerns that these irregularities indicate a more intentional strategy, not yet publicly discussed, to mislead, intimidate, dominate, and manipulate public officials, service organizations, voters, and the people of Whatcom County for the purpose of expanding the Jail Industrial Complex Act taxpayer expense. Section D, ancillary concerns. Beyond those indicated above, there are other indications our law enforcement policies and practices may need review for excessive force and potential violations of civil liberties. For example, in the recent past, we have seen, 1, the creation of a 501c3 Sheriff's Foundation to do projects for the sheriff that are not funded by the Whatcom County Council. 2, 4 police-caused deaths apparently excused by the prosecutor. 3, multiple suicides inside the Whatcom County Jail. 4, what seems to be an excessive number of SWAT team call-outs, SWAT practices at schools with students present, and the Western Washington University riot, now widely perceived as having been escalated by the police.
30 seconds, please.
5, aggressive efforts to bring in surveillance software, armoring, and heavy military equipment continues in spite of continuous public testimony and opposition. 6, exaggerated reporting and dramatic demonstrations by the sheriff, including inflammatory assertions and unusual actions to influence public opinion, such as claiming there are 31 Whatcom County gangs with 900 members and associates, hosting events with armed officers and serving warrants and conducting sweeps that intimidate the public with excessive shows of force. Together, these indicate an aggressive executive branch initiative towards excessive incarceration and
time.
For a jail size. May I finish the sentences? And for a jail size, style, and location that has not been sufficiently justified. The system was gamed for a predetermined outcome that is not in the public's best interests. The use or misuse of power and public funds should be investigated. Pre-booking jail alternatives should be prioritized, and a jail adjacent to the courthouse should be carefully considered. Submitted by the Restorative Community Coalition, a digital edition of this document is available at restorativecommunity.com, and all hyperlinks are active, and there is much research available there.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Doug Gustafson, and I just wanted to bring up, everybody tonight had a lot of good points on the, for being against the construction of a new jail, mostly from a mailer standpoint, and also from a moral standpoint or a civil liberty standpoint. But I wanted to make a different argument on the same point, which is fiscal responsibility, right? So, if you look at the budget report on the main Whatcom County Executive's website, you'll see that the Whatcom County budget is made up of 55% of law and justice. So, my logic is take this forward into the future. After you build this jail, you're going to have to fill all the beds because that's the only way that it's financially viable. There's going to be more incentives to lock people up. It's going to take up more of the budget, and it ends up being this vicious cycle where the county just gets completely drained of funds, and we need to turn it back to a virtuous cycle where we use those funds, we redirect them to prevent this from occurring in the first place, and to develop economically the community so that people have more opportunities, so they choose those options more, and you end up with fewer people locked up. A lot of this is related to poverty too, that the people don't have opportunities, they mess around, and they end up in jail. We got to figure out how to turn this around so that we don't just keep continuously locking more and more people up. We have more people in jail than any country any country in the world. We have 25% of the world's prisoners. Obviously, there's something dysfunctional or weird about our system that we have so many people locked up, but other countries don't, not even authoritarian countries. So it's really kind of odd, and I think we got to figure out how to make this happen at the local level, turn it around so that we don't end up with 50% of the world's prisoners, you know? So anyway, that's all I wanted to say, and take it easy.
Thank you.
Good evening. Sherry Lambert, Whatcom County. We're not, I'm not, and the people that I talk to are not opposed to a new jail. We need a new jail. I've toured this one, and it is totally inadequate. But we're opposed to a 521-bed jail. I'd like to know what percentage of the people that are in jail are there because of substance abuse and mental illness. I think that money should be going to take care of that problem. Let's hit it in the beginning, take care of these people, and keep them out of jail. It makes no sense while at the federal level and the state level, they're trying to get people out of jail at this time because they realize that it's a waste of money. We need to get these people back being, hopefully, productive members of society. So the objection is the size of the jail, and that's all I have to say on that. Thank you.
Thank you. If there's anybody else after this gentleman, come on down.
My name is Everett Barton. And I've said it all today in my letter. It was printed in the Herald. Whatcom County does not need a penitentiary out in the same plot of ground where Hovander Park and the wildlife refuge is. Just, I think the whole county would agree to that.
Thank you.
How you doing? My name is Tyler Ryan. I live in unincorporated Bellingham out in Whatcom County. I support this. I think that everybody knows that this is an obligation that the executive and the county government has to inform its voters. I've noticed that everybody that's come up here in opposition has also come in with political buttons on them, things like that, and I think that you guys are all smart and intelligent and can recognize that this is a coordinated political act. This is a witch hunt, okay? You've got someone who's losing in the polls to Jack Laus. She's trying to put together an opposition to get some press. That's what this is, okay? And you guys know that. So if you guys are really after a witch hunt, then, or if you guys are really after looking into an investigation and finding something, I have one for you. In over the past several years, the Whatcom County Council has given money to an organization called RE Sources. Are you guys, I'm not sure if you're familiar with them. They're also a political action committee that's been the source of backing Proposition 9 and 10. So, no, I mean, they've filed a PDC report. So you guys have given them money after they've filed PDC disclosures. So the money that's been given, I mean, for people that don't like abuse in government and are concerned about things, I think you should really look at that because that's a direct violation. Giving money to an organization that is out, just they're not even hiding it. They're just saying, yeah, we're out pushing. I mean, if you go to their website, it says activate, political activate. That's who you guys are giving money to. And so I think that if we're going to start running around picking on Jack and the county for putting together a mailer that really, this mailer was fine. There was nothing in it that said vote for it or against it. It just explained the problem. And I think that the voters, this was no different than Skagit's jail poster. This is no different than all the bond levies that we get. So if you guys are going to make a big deal about that, I think you guys need to look at yourselves, too. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else? Come on up front.
My name is Brooks Anderson, and thank you for listening to all of us. My first response in terms of listening to everybody who's come up here tonight is, what can you do about it? I mean, really, this is about the voters deciding, and it's giving a place for people who have strong feelings to come and speak about the mailer and other things, but you can't make this decision. So why is it being put on you to listen to it? This discussion, these points, all, many of which are wonderful and have real basis, should have been done long time ago. The tragedy in this is that the mailer and the heat of the campaign is that it's right before the voting. And all it's just causing huge confusion to people who are the voters. How are they going to vote? As someone mentioned earlier, most people who are not actively involved and interested, they haven't maybe one clue about the thing about the jail proposition, the fact that it's being proposed to fund it with just a sales tax, and that's a lot of the objection to this. It's been a really difficult, conflicting approach. So again, I ask the question, why are you being asked, I guess you're being asked, to make, I don't know, you can't solve this. You know, it may be last year or 6 months ago, working with the county executive and the other cities, if there had been more conversation about it and more information about it, maybe we would be in a different place than we are now. I really, I voted for Jack Lyles last time, and I considered him a pretty fair person with good experience to be a county executive. This whole thing about the jail and his way of dealing with this has really disappointed me, I have to say. I feel like this is the one issue where we haven't seen him use his collaborative skills, be willing to work things
seconds,
out.
30 seconds, please.
30 seconds already? So, but again, I guess the biggest thing I wanted to say is, why are we thinking you're going to solve this? You're not. It's the voters who are going to solve it. And then if it gets voted in, some people think we can look at it in different ways. If it gets voted out, then we have to have a new jail, but not the way this one is financed and not the other things that are involved in it. So, again, why are you being asked to resolve this?
Thank you. Anybody else?
Carol McDonald, 8174 Mount Baker Highway. Three things. I've toured the jail. It's disgusting. In my opinion, we need a new jail, and we needed it yesterday. Secondly, the mailer was wonderfully done, in my opinion. I had heard a lot of talk, for which I was very disappointed. I think one elected official trying to tear down another elected official is not something that I appreciate. And number three, about Jack Lau's shaking hands here. Every county council meeting I've been to, Jack walks around and shakes everybody's hand. So I didn't see that as him trying to get us to vote for him. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's Alan Hall. I'm from Bellingham. I've read the mailer too, and my first thought was, this is a giant piece of propaganda designed to get people to vote for this issue. And I've seen a lot of propaganda in my time. I served under Ronald Reagan during the end of the Cold War, so we were well versed in that. And this mailer was just that. It was designed specifically to get people to vote for it. And I think that's wrong. And even if this does get voted on and approved, I don't think this jail law should stand. I mean, I think there are some points that could be made to get it struck from the law. Building a 520-some bed jail when we really should have been spending money on mental illness and drug treatment the whole time, well, that's why it's overcrowded as it is, and we haven't maintained it. But building more beds, what are you gonna, the only thing to do then is fill them up. You have a guy with a mental illness, throw him in jail. A guy who is drunk and disorderly, nonviolent, throw him in jail. That's your answer. Well, it's not going to solve our problems. Building a bigger jail won't solve any of our problems, except overcrowding. But that could be solved by many other different means, and means that hopefully aren't brought to the public through a propaganda publication that we paid for. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else? If there's other people, if you'll come down front, we've got other business to do yet this evening.
Hi, my name is Deborah Hawley, and I am the founder of an organization, MORE, for Public Support of Prison Reform, and the MORE stands for Mothers and Others Rallying and Educating for Public Support of Prison Reform. And I feel kind of nervous and kind of emotional tonight. I don't and didn't have anything particularly planned to say, but I do have a few things that I'd like to share. First of all, prison doesn't just happen. It starts in jail with a jail sentence. And in my case, started with both of my sons in juvenile detention and then in Whatcom County Jail. My oldest son is currently serving his third prison sentence in Washington State. And I asked my group a couple of weeks ago that I founded for those who have loved ones in prison or jail, the group that meets here in Whatcom County, I asked him a couple weeks ago how many of us would be sitting in the room right now with an incarcerated loved one if we had had diversion programs in place at the time that our children or our husbands or what have you had been incarcerated in the jail. I want to just say that I believe sitting on the peripheral seats of the every other Monday jail task force meetings, that I believe that, you know, whatever I get from this, from people, I don't care. I believe most people are well-intentioned. I believe that everybody is doing the best job that they can. I believe that they see their worldview through their own lens. And I have to say that through my lens, I see a lopsided, disproportionate representation of what needs to happen when you bring a whole system with everybody sitting at the table, that I've realized in the last 24 hours that I have just as much of a silent voice on the outside of the wall doing the time with my son as does my son and the others on the other side of the wall, whether it be in jail or prison, have. Because, honestly, I feel underrepresented. And I didn't get the flyer, or maybe I did. I don't know. But I didn't see it in my mailbox. And it makes no difference
30 seconds, please.
To me personally whether I got it or not. Because I don't need to see a flyer to see what a jail inmate looks like. Because I've had one, and that's my son, for 18 years. We need to start being listened to, those of us that see this stuff firsthand. Thank you.
Thank you. Last chance. Anyone else? Okay, I'm going to close the open session.